looks nourishing. Here you go. What's your face? Glad to see you're still kicking around. I can't believe it's all still... here. Oh, Jack. I guess I forgot about this one. I can do it now. Fluid. I need to apply it in the right order. Soon. It needs to stay in longer. Photo I took of you, Jack. Shit. Room. It's like he never... I used to think I'd never fit in. But Jack, he didn't mind my weirdness. He kept telling me I was special. Jack was a humble, religious man. He ran a funeral home, and I'd help out whenever I could. It felt good to be useful. Keep hissing at me. Who do you think's gonna feed you now? Jack was part of the solidarity movement. He spent a few months in an internment camp, but even that couldn't dampen his spirit. Come on, Jack. Where'd you put it? Okay. Let's do this the other way. Okay, I think that's it. Jack's waiting downstairs. Time to say goodbye. Weird to be back in my old room. So many memories. Yeah. I used to have a thing for him. I guess they just used to make me happy. Jack knew it well. That's why there's so many of them here. Kids from the orphanage. Not all of them had my luck. That's why I kept coming back. To play. To take care of them. To listen. That was the least I could do. I used to get a lot of these. To me, they were like trophies. Badges of honor for doing the right thing. Jack wasn't too amused, but he did his best to cover for me. I kind of feel bad for making him go through all that. My oldest family heirloom. As a kid, I'd show this to people just to freak them out. I'd usually say something like, "Pretty sick, huh?" I was such a dork. We lived upstairs from Jack's funeral home. It wasn't as weird as it sounds. Besides, if it wasn't for that, I may never have learned to use my powers.